Hello people, in this video let us look at meth hemoglobin. So it is nothing but a type of hemoglobin. So you can see it is meth hemoglobin. So it's a type of hemoglobin. So you can see here normal hemoglobin has ferrous, right? The iron form in hemoglobin is ferrous, but in meth hemoglobin, because of some free radicals, etc., some poisons like nitrates, dapsone, and chloroquine, some drugs. So meth hemoglobin can form, which has ferric. This cannot deliver oxygen well, so it cannot deliver the oxygen to the tissue. That's what you have to understand here. So look at this table from the textbook. So you have methemoglobinemia, which has been indicated here. That means there is methemoglobin in the blood. So methemoglobinemia. So they're showing you the causes here. The causes can be congenital, or there can be some oxidizing agents, right? That is what's the free radical they are talking about. So you can have nitrates, let's remember nitrates, dapsone, chloroquine, and some other things, okay? As a consequence, what happens, the dissociation curve is shifted to the left, so it does not dissociate. That's what they're trying to say here. So here you can see the saturation is more, they are saying it's actually shifted to left. The this is very interesting. It is saying that it cannot deliver the oxygen to the tissue. That is what they are saying, it will shift to the left, okay? Okay, so now we have understood this. So the oxygen delivery to the tissue is reduced. They're very specific about it. The oxygen delivery is reduced. There is an apparent cyanosis. Obviously, if the tissues are not getting oxygen, there's an apparent cyanosis. Breathlessness will be there. Obviously, this person's not getting oxygen. Breathlessness, fatigue, headache, chest pain, delirium, impaired consciousness, seizures, etc. in severe cases. Now, how will you treat this? You will have to treat this with methyl thionium chloride, okay, or methylene blue, they are saying. So this thio, right, T-H-I-O, methyl thionium chloride, are you able to see here? So that's what they have indicated here. You will give methyl thionium chloride, it will convert this methemoglobin into hemoglobin, right? It will convert methemoglobin into hemoglobin. It itself will get it will become the oxidized form. So it is in the reduced form, it will become the oxidized form. So methemoglobin will go back to hemoglobin, okay? So what will you give that person? Methylene blue. So this reduces methemoglobin. See below, they have said, yeah, we have seen. Used for symptomatic patients with severe methemoglobinemia. Only if they have severe methemoglobinemia, then only you are doing all this. Patients with anemia and other comorbidities may need treatment at lower concentrations. You should not give so much, okay? So what is the treatment for methemoglobinemia? Say methylene blue. Methylene blue. It is also methyl thionium chloride. Okay, methyl thionium chloride, very important to remember. Okay.